Okay, Nana. So part two. Already we have discussed properties of rational numbers under addition. Now we are going to discuss properties of rational numbers under multiplication. Properties of rational numbers under multiplication. Okay. So already, what is our first property? You all know that is closure. What is the first property? Closure. So what is here closure property? What? In the same as in addition here also. So if A and B are rational numbers, if A and B are rational numbers, then A into B belongs to A rational number. So A into B belongs to A rational. It is multiplication. So instead of plus, we are using here multiply. Okay, multiplication symbol. So A into B will belongs to again a rational number. Example. So 2 by 3, A is equal to 2 by 3, B is equal to 1 by 3. So come on, A into B. Substitute here, A into B is 2 by 3 into 1 by 3. So 2 1s are 2, 3 3s are 9. So it is in the form of again B by 2. So it belongs to rational number. It belongs to rational number. So this is our first property under multiplication. In the same way, second property, what I told them? What is our second property? Commutative property. Second property is commutative property. If A and B are rational numbers, then A into B is equal to B into A. A into B is equal to B into A. In the same way, take examples and you verify. A into B is equal to B into A. 2 3s are is 6. In the same way, 3 2s are also 6. So 2 3s are is 6. 3 2s are also 6. So it holds under multiplication. Next, associative. Third property is associative. As in associative, how many rational numbers it will have? Associative property. So if A, B and C, it involves three rational numbers. A, B and C are rational numbers. Then same as addition only. So A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. Okay. All of you listen. A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. That means first we should simplify the bracket thing. So B into C we have to multiply and next we go for the A. Okay. So take one example and you do. Okay. This is our associative. Next, fourth property is multiplicative identity. So what is multiplicative identity? Additive identity we call it as zero. So multiplicative identity. So what is here multiplicative identity? 1. What is multiplicative identity? 1. So what is here multiplicative identity? If A is a rational number, then A into 1 is equal to 1 into A is equal to A. 2 1s are 2. 1 2s are 2. So here 1 we call it as multiplicative identity. Fifth property, multiplicative inverse. So what is your multiplicative inverse? So if A is a rational number, then what is inverse for the A? 1 by A. That is A into 1 by A is equal to 1 by A into A is equal to 1. So A cancel, what is the value left with here? 1. So A cancel, what is the value left with here? 1. So what is the inverse for A? 1 by A. What is the inverse for 2? 1 by 2. What is the inverse for 2 by 3? 3 by 2. Okay. So multiplicative inverse, what is the rule here? a into 1 by a is equal to 1 by a into a is equal to 1. So final property, distributive property. Final property is distributive property. Sixth property, we not seeing under addition, we are seeing under multiplication. This is sixth property. Distributive property. So what is your distributive property? If A, B, C are rational numbers, this property also involves three rational numbers, that is A, B, C. So what is your rule? If A, B, C are rational numbers, then what is your property? A plus of B plus, sorry, A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. A into B plus A into C. This is our distributive property rule. So it involves into and addition, multiplication and addition. So A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. So we'll take example, Nana. A is equal to 1 by 2, B is equal to 3 by 2, C is equal to 5 by 2. So what is your distributive property? A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. A into B plus A into C. This is the property. Substitute and check whether the distributive property holds or not. So A value how much, Nana? 1 by 2 into B value how much? 3 by 2. C value is 5 by 2 is equal to A into B, 1 by 2 into 3 by 2. Next, plus A value is 1 by 2. C value is 5 by 2. So, 1 by 2 into, your denominators are same. So, directly we will have the numerators. 3 plus 5 is 8 by 2. So, 1 3 is 3. 2 2 is 4. 1 5 is 5. 2 2 is 4. So, now see, Nana. Now, what happened here? 1 by 2 into 8 by 2. So, 1 8 is 8. 2 2 is 4. So, your denominators are same. We'll add directly numerator. So, 3 plus 5, 8 by 4. So, what happened here? 8 by 4 is equal to 8 by 4. So, LHS is equal to RHS. By this, we can conclude it holds under distributive. It holds under distributive. Okay, now. So, these are the properties under addition and under multiplication. So, these things you have to know to do the exercise 1.1. So, we'll see now. Exercise 1.1, first bit. So, what is the first bit given? Name the property. Name the property involved. Exercise 1.1. Name the property involved in the following. Name the property involved. So, exercise 1.1. Exercise 1.1, first bit. So, what is your first bit given? Name the property involved in the following examples. Which property it is involving? First one. So, what is given here? 8 by 5 plus 0 is equal to 8 by 5. Is equal to 0 plus 8 by 5. So, if you observe this, addition. Addition. And 0 is there. So, addition 0. What we call it as 0? What it told? 0 is called as additive identity. 0 is called as additive identity. So, what is the Indian property is involving here? Identity property under addition. You can write as additive identity. Additive identity. Is it clear? First, we have to check whether it is holding under multiplication. What is there here? Symbol plus or into, we have to check. Next, what? Next term we have to check. Then we can write the property. Second one. So, 2 into 3 by 5 plus 1 by 2 is equal to 2 into 3 by 5 plus 2 into 1 by 2. So, which property this is? Just now I told it is involving 3. It is involving three rational numbers. One is here, nothing means into one into is here, one plus is there. So what is the last property I told you? Distributive property. See here, 2 into 3 and 2 into 1 by 2. So it holds distributive property. Distributive property. We have to check up. Next, third one. So 3 by 7 into 1 is equal to 3 by 7 is equal to 1 into 3 by 7. So first check the symbol. So whatever symbol into is there, that means it is under multiplication. And next go for the next numbers. 1 is there. So multiplication and 1. Multiplication and 1. So multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity. If you know this, know the properties, then only you can do the exercise. Otherwise, you can't. So fourth one, minus 2 by 5 into 1 is equal to minus 2 by 5 is equal to 1 into minus 2 by 5. So if we observe here, what happened? Multiplication. 1 is there, 1 is there. So, into n1 same as third one. Which property? Multiplicative identity. Fifth one, 2 by 5 plus 1 by 3 is equal to 1 by 3 plus 2 by 5. So, see here, 2 by 5, 1 by 3. Plus, so it's under addition. So, 2 by 5, 1 by 3. Here, 1 by 3, 2 by 5. So, A plus B is equal to B plus A. A plus B is equal to B plus A. That is what rule that is? Commutative. Under addition. Commutative under addition. This is the now we have to mention here. Whether it is multiplication or addition. Next, sixth one. So, what is here sixth one? 5 by 2 into 3 by 7. 5 by 2 into 3 by 7. So, 5 3s are 15. Directly given. 2 7s are 14. So, this is called as multiplication is there. Direct to multiply did here. So, it is nothing but closure. Under multiplication. Closure under multiplication. Is it clear, beta? Why I explain first properties? Okay. So, this is the first bit of your exercise 1.1. Okay. Next to second page. So what is the second bit given here? Write the additive and multiplicative inverse. Write the additive and multiplicative inverse. So we have to write additive inverse as well as multiplicative inverse. So second bit. So, first one. So, what is given here? Minus 3 by 5. What is given? Minus 3 by 5. Solution. So, we have to write additive inverse and multiplicative inverse. So, what additive inverse means? Minus unte plus, so plus unte minus. So, here minus 3 by 5 is there. So, it will get plus 3 by 5. This plus 3 by 5. Multiplicative inverse means it will becomes reverse. 3 by 5 will becomes 5 by 3. So, symbol is there. Symbol will not change. Whatever given in the question, that only will get here sign. So, minus 5 by 3. Minus 3 by 5 will take minus 5 by 3. Is it clear? So, second one. 1 is given here. So, additive inverse. Multiplicative inverse. So, what is additive inverse here? 1 means plus 1. So here you will get minus 1. Multiplicative inverse means 1 by 1 means 1. 1 by 1 means 1. Okay. Third one, 0. Additive inverse we have to write. Multiplicative inverse we have to write. So what is here? 0 carat inverse? 0. Multiplicative inverse and 1 by 0. So not defined. 1 by 0 means not defined. So, additive inverse is 0. Multiplicative inverse, we cannot define here. Fourth one, 7 by 9. So, additive inverse Multiplicative inverse. So additive inverse 7/9 plus nothing means plus 7/9. So what is your additive inverse? -7/9. So what is your multiplicative inverse? 9/7. This is your second bit of exercise 1.1.